experience that if you have an eating disorder, or at least in my case, and I know that a lot of my friends that go through the same thing feel the same way, any kind of vacation or thing where you're out of your element and you don't have your rigid schedule and you're not used to it, it's mind like blowing. It honestly turns my world upside down, and I'm just in Bentonville and I live in Carthage, so like it's an hour and a half, not a big deal, but I also don't have a car, so a lot of power's taken away in a way, and that definitely freaks me out. I have a very rigid schedule. I wake up at 6. I wake up at 6 o'clock, do yoga and Pilates, and then I will like do a couple ab workouts, and obviously like this is part of my eating disorder that makes me feel like I need to do this, and I'm trying to work over that, but I also have enjoyment for doing it as well.
And strong and beautiful, most girls work hard, go far, we are unstoppable. Most girls are fighting to make every day, no two are the same. I wanna be like, I wanna be like most girls. I wanna be like most girls. I wanna be like
what the heck? He literally must have died. Ugh. It's almost been 30 minutes. My dad said he's gonna be back in like 5, so. But anyway, it is Monday, and Mondays kind of stink. One that's school, then I'm like, but it's just another day, folks. Talk about cellulite and just loving your body. What if you have a little bit of cellulite or you jiggle? Like,
everyone has to roll.
That's normal. Like, or fat rolls. Like, everyone has like some stomach. Like, that's the way it is. Sorry, I'm moving my chair, but I'm fat. Like, look at this. Oh no. I'm dying. Like, you're fine. Join the club. Everyone does. Especially girls. Like, I don't know about guys, but girls, we're supposed to be carrying a baby in here one day. Like, everyone has baby talk. Just the way it is. And there's a holiday coming up, 4th of July, so holidays are also really stressful. Christmas, Easter, they're not necessarily even happy things for me to look forward to. They're things that I'm like,
oh my god, like no, shit,
I can't do this. Like, I'm gonna have to be with family, I'm gonna have to, okay, rewind, sorry, that sounds bad. It's not that I just don't want to be with my family, it's that there's no escape in a way, because like the thoughts are there, but I have to pretend that they're not, because I'm constantly surrounded by people. And people may think that that's a good thing, like having like people around you talking all the time, but it's really not in some cases, because I can't have a way to get out my thoughts. Like, I can't just, because it's obviously not their fault. And I think the hardest thing about holidays is the food. In America, I don't know if it's different in different countries, or maybe it's different in different families, but definitely in my family, in both sides of my family, food and holidays are a big thing. Like, in one side of my family, my mom's side, we have about like 20 pies every holiday, almost, it seems like. And I love pie, like that's awesome, but it definitely is triggering, and all the food isn't really necessarily healthy. But I mean, honestly, so I can't just be like, no, we can't have anything. Like, I don't want you guys. So I just have to kind of deal with it. And in a way, I probably do seem, honestly, probably really rude. And I hate that. And I hate that my family might think that I'm rude at times without even meaning to. Yes, I'm talking to myself. It's hard because, you know, when you're surrounded by food, that's your worst enemy. So it is, in a way, like if you're afraid of heights and you are having to, every single holiday, you have to go up in the tallest skyscraper, and it's also made out of glass. So everywhere you like step, you think you're gonna fall. And like, I can't imagine how bad that would be if you have a fear of heights, but that's how it is, because holidays are supposed to be happy for me, but they're really not, because it's everywhere you look, there's food. Everywhere you look, there's people offering you food. And that's not even just a thing because they know about my eating disorder. It's just a,
hey, Merry Christmas, here's some candy, I don't have to eat Easter, here's some chocolate.
And I obviously don't want them to not ask me, because then I feel like they're excluding me. So it's very complicated, and I know that. And I know that it's very hard for people to know what is right and wrong, but I also don't want people to think that when you have an eating disorder, you have to be like not talked to as a normal person. And I honestly just wish sometimes people would talk to me as if I didn't have an eating disorder, or like they didn't know about it, because people, it really does change how people talk to you, or some people talk to you, and how they handle situations with you. And there are certain situations that need to be dealt with differently, but I think the biggest thing is like, don't talk to me like if you bring up a type of food, then I'm gonna like stab you. Like, it's not like that. And I think a misconception that a lot of people have is that people with anorexia are very judgmental about other people's bodies, and that's not really the case. I don't know if like how that really got started, and maybe like other people might have that problem, but with me and a lot of the people that I know, it's not like that. It's, we're so worried about ourselves. And I think this is a lot with teen girls or anyone. Like, you're so worried about yourself. When you look on to the left of you or the right of you, if you're watching someone like down a cheeseburger, the only thing you're looking at is that cheeseburger, thinking, man, I wish I could eat that and not feel bad about it. Like, I wish I could eat that piece of cake without being upset and wanting to cry. And if they know that you have an eating disorder and you're like looking at them while they're eating food, I think a lot of people think that you're judging them, and that's not it. It really isn't. Like, when I look at a family friend or relative or anyone that's eating something, it's not because I'm like, they need to stop eating that cheeseburger. I'm like, wow, I wish I could be doing that. Like, that cheeseburger looks really good. I want that right now. I'd rather be having that than my kale salad. And I...
So if you want to talk to me, I'd like to know that we are to be talking to yourself. Thank you.